everyone, and welcome to another how-to session. Today we're going to be talking about how to be a good friend. And this is a topic that is dear to a lot of people because they are in places where they are confined a lot, or they don't get to see their friends as much, but they still want to be able to maintain that bond and maintain that friendship with them. So what can you do, or how can you still be a friend even when it seems like there is no end in sight, or even when it seems like we are in our house cooped up forever? So these are some of the tips that I think might help you. Number one, be there for them, especially when they're in a tough spot. This means if your friend, for example, is going through a very difficult situation and they need someone to be there for them, just to listen to them even on the phone while they're dealing with this, be there for them. Don't just turn them off or say you're too busy to listen to them or talk to them. Like, make the effort to be available when they need you to be available. And this kind of ties into the next point, which is check in on them to make sure they're okay. A lot of us, and sometimes myself included, we tend to put up a whole facade or a whole different picture of how we are actually feeling, when in reality we are going through a lot of things and navigating emotions and situations. And it's not often that people will write to you and ask you, hey, by the way, how are you today? I thought about you, you know. And if a friend does that, if someone reaches out to you and asks you how you are, personally, if they reach out to me and ask me genuinely how I am, I'm always happy to respond and, you know, kick off the conversation and tell them how I actually am, as opposed to just saying, oh, I'm fine, and just moving on. But actually talking to them, that is if they are genuine. So when you are checking in on them, be genuine about it. Don't just write a one-liner to say, how are you, or hope you're fine. You know, put yourself in that person's shoes and be more empathetic towards how they're going, and more of a human being in the way that you speak. Like, have some emotion and some affection or care in the way that you ask people how they are, instead of it just being a everyday cliche kind of a statement. The other one is stand up or stick up for them, especially when you feel like they're being bullied, because in this internet day and age, a lot of people like to bully others and put them down if, for example, they've had an achievement or they have an opinion and not everyone is agreeing with what they're saying. Be the one to stand up for them and be there for them. You don't have to make a public display. You can just reach out to them in their inbox or their messages, or call them up and be like, hey, I support what you're saying. I may not understand it, but I support you and I support your opinions. And regardless of your differences, because really at the end of the day, you are still going to be friends. You're going to have differences, but that doesn't mean that you ruin the friendship that you have. Advise them when they ask for your help. And I think this is one of the points that is extremely overlooked. People, when a friend comes to you, or when anyone comes to you and is genuinely asking you for advice, take the time to give them the advice, because you don't know what they're going through. You don't know how what you tell them, or even just that small amount of time you give them, can make their day. Because people are going through so many different things, situations. Maybe they're dealing with issues you have no idea about and they just want an ear to listen to. And if they come to you and they say, hey Maria, or hey Patricia, I'm going through this, how can I deal with this situation? And they may not even tell you that it's them who is going through it. They may speak about it in like a roundabout way, but you will get the picture, and you giving them advice will show them that you care about them, you care about their well-being, and you really want to be a good friend to them. Correct them respectfully when you feel that they are in the wrong. So now this is the thing. You don't have to agree with everything your friend says. At times are going to be instances where your friend goes overboard or crosses the line and you are torn between keeping quiet or confronting them about it. In my experience, it's always good to confront them about it, but confront them in a respectful way from a place of love. Like, don't come and talk down on them, reprimand them and say, hey, you can't do this, you know, like basically belittling them. No, like, sit down with them or call them up and say, hey, by the way, I know this and this is happening, and I know I don't fully understand why you're doing what you're doing or what happened, but I just want to say that maybe you could have handled it in a different way that wouldn't have caused all this that's going on, you know? Like, just tell them you're only talking to them because you care about them, and like, talk to them from a place of love, from a place of care and genuineness. Don't be disingenuous about it. Don't be the person who is gloating or saying good on you, you deserve this. Because they are your friend, you want to talk to them from a place of respect for them, for yourself, and for everyone else that has been affected by the situation. Share opportunities with them to help them grow. Don't be selfish. If you come across an opportunity on the internet or wherever and you think this may be something that your friend will benefit from, don't be stingy. Like, don't keep it to yourself and say, oh, this is my precious, I'm not going to share this with anyone. Fine, you will benefit from it, but then after that immediate gratification, what next? Are you like only looking to leg up yourself, or do you also want your friend to level up? So like, if you come across like opportunities, if it's a school, a scholarship opportunity, a work opportunity, an event opportunity, a speaking engagement opportunity, a networking event opportunity, any opportunity you think would be good to your friend, good for your friend or beneficial for them, share it with them. It doesn't hurt, because even if you don't get it, and if they get it, they will be grateful to you and they will want to give back as well. And this will spark a community of people who give back, which is important in today's society. Cheer them on whenever they accomplish a feat or get recognized for their work. Don't be the green-eyed monster. Don't be jealous. Don't be the one who is a downer of the party or the one who makes them feel ashamed for having accomplished what they have accomplished. I mean, you're their friend, so you are the one who needs to cheer them up and congratulate them and be like, job well done, you know? Be in their corner and root for them, because that's what they need from a friend. They don't need a friend who is stabbing them in the back or talking behind their back and saying all sorts of nonsense when they aren't hearing, and then coming to them and giving them crocodile smiles or things that are not, like, just not being honest with them. And friends, if you really want to be a good friend to your friend, and if you want them to be a good friend to you too, then like, celebrate each other, cheer each other on. Don't be jealous because they did something that you didn't do, and maybe you wanted to do it but you didn't have the chance to do it, or it wasn't your time. Your time will come, and when your time comes, you will at least have the assurance that your friend will be there to cheer you on too. Forgive them when they hurt you. They will grow to respect you for your selflessness. I'm telling you this, like, I've been hurt by friends too, been talked about and all that stuff that friends do. I mean, that's just how life is. And maybe in some cases I wasn't a perfect friend either, but you reach a point and you're like, okay, do you really want this to go on forever? The both of you just being angry or upset and frustrated at each other? Or do you want to be the kind of friend who forgives and says, oh, that's water under the bridge? is your friendship that valuable? Is it valuable enough for you to say, it's okay, I forgive you? Or are you the kind of person who holds onto grudges forever and doesn't let go and doesn't give up until the other person comes and says sorry first? Like, be the better person. And when you're the better person, then the other person will learn from you and they will be a better person to someone else too. And that's really the point of living, is being able to love everyone, to love and live with each other in harmony. And don't we all want that? Cherish them. Do not let distance or time come between your friendship. Make them a priority. Don't let other things that are not as important in the moment come in between your friendship. Yes, we're all busy. Yes, we all have things to do. Yes, we all have our priorities and stuff, but there comes a point in life where you ask yourself, what are your values? You know, like, okay, yes, I have to work to make a living, pay my rent, pay the bills, buy food, travel if I want to, study and all that stuff. You have your life goals, okay. But then what about your personal goals that ground you, the people or the base that is your foundation? Are you investing in them, or are you thinking that you can just go through life being by yourself? And it's okay if you think that way, but there comes a point where you realize that maybe you would have been a better person if you had people who valued you in your life, who you could call friends, who you could reach out to when you're in a tough spot. And if you don't cherish the ones you have now, then you're not gonna have any friends down the line. So, I mean, that's really a call that you have to make, is can you make time, even if it's checking in on them once a week, even if it's having a phone call with them once a week, doing a Skype or having a chat or a coffee date, things like that. You don't have to check on them every day, God no, but at least once a week, just to know how they're doing, catch up on them, and so that they know that they matter to you, you know, as you matter to them. But lastly, celebrate important dates with them. This could be anniversaries, birthdays, graduations, promotions, you know, those kinds of things. Like things, days and dates that matter to them, celebrate it with them. Don't forget these dates. Put it in your calendar, put it in your phone, set a reminder every year and say, oh yeah, today her birthday is coming up, this is what I'm gonna do for her. And even if you just call to wish her a happy birthday, or send her a note, or send her a gift or a present, like tiny things, you don't have to go to the extreme. You can, you know, just do small things, and you know that she will appreciate them, or he will appreciate them, depending on who your friends are. Remembering those dates really makes people feel special. I know I feel special when someone remembers to wish me a happy birthday. I even feel more special when they call me up and wish me a happy birthday, and I feel extremely special when they gift me a present for my birthday. So you get the gist, right? So yeah, like, go out of your way to show them that you remember days that are important to them. And so that's it for today's tips. I hope that helps some of you improve your relationships, grow your friendships, and have beautiful friends who value you and who will be your bedrock. Have a lovely day.